The president approved a phased and gradual easing of the lockdown from Monday, 4th May 2020. And joining us now via phone is legal practitioner Ebun Adegboruwa. Thank you, Ebun, for joining us.
Thank you.
You did hear the president's nation address. I want to know for you what stood out for you and if our concerns were addressed and our fears allayed by the nation addressed by the president.
Well, I think that as much as we anticipated that the lockdown would be eased, the challenge with Nigeria presently is that whether in lockdown or ease of movement, there's galloping inflation, the exchange rate of the Naira, the drop in the price of oil, is predicting a challenging economy ahead of all of us. And I'm sure you know that the rains have come. People are going to be confronted with mass flooding in not too distant time from now. And I doubt the capacity of the preparedness of the government for that. So prior to COVID-19, we had problem of the economic capacity of the current government, given that most Nigerians are outside of job. So I believe that the present challenge we are facing is beyond presidential broadcasts. There's need very urgently for the government to tinker with its economic team for the purpose of job creation, for the purpose of ensuring stable supply of electricity, and develop other critical infrastructure for Nigeria to move forward. I don't think that we should lose focus of the incompetence of this government in terms of not fulfilling its promises to Nigerians. The issue of fiscal federalism is there and unresolved. So I believe that we should not be carried away by COVID-19. The peculiar problems in Nigeria have continued to stare us in the face. And this is only but a distraction from the economic catastrophe that Nigeria is currently facing. So I do not share the enthusiasm of many from this presidential broadcast, mindful of the fact that Nigeria had its own peculiar problems prior to COVID-19. Yes. But having said that, it is important to say that the presidential address reflects clearly a president who has learned and heard of the general concerns of Nigerians from a lockdown in an economy that is not productive. So to that extent, I think it is commendable that the president seems to have listened to the cries of Nigerians. But beyond that, we have a greater problem ahead. If you look at the statistics that we have now, in the course of this lockdown, we have only crossed the 10,000 limit in testing. And out of that 10,000, over 1,000 are actively positive. So that gives you an average of 10%. And if we are 200 million people and we are tested positive with 10%, we are looking at 20 million people positive in the coming time. So if you take more than 1 month to do 10,000 tests, you can imagine how long it will take us to do 200 million. So I think it's important to ramp up the testing capacity and ensure that a greater number of people are tested. And finally, I think it's important for government to come out to tell our people the truth. The situation that people are facing in terms of COVID-19 is far more than you can imagine. And government is not telling Nigerians the truth about the capacity that has been built to contain this system. Thank you very much.
Yeah, Mr. Ebun, I do hear you when you say the government is not coming out with the truth completely on the situation of the pandemic. Now, why do you think this is the situation? And what can be done about this? Because similarly, confidence needs to be reposed back to the people by the government. What is critical at this point in time?
I think that there is a wide gap between capacity actually and propaganda in the newspapers and the media. In the past 2 or 3 days, I had a personal experience where a close friend of mine who could not get tested and is yet to be tested. And the reality is that the testing kits have been exhausted. Most instruments that are used have been exhausted. And there is a backlog of so many people who are waiting and cannot be attended to. And you recall that just yesterday, Mr. Arije, a lawyer, died in the course of evacuation to circumstances related to COVID-19. So what I mean by government is not telling us the truth is that we hear that people are not coming out to be tested and government has capacity, whereas there is no capacity. And it's important that we have the understanding to assist government in coming to tackle this monster. But we must do so with the correct information.
All right, Mr. Ebun, just before I let you go tonight, he did also border on palliative distribution and said it still will be ongoing despite the lockdown before the new relaxed order comes into effect. Now, people have complained that most of these palliatives being distributed is not necessarily getting to those it's meant for. What would you suggest by way of homegrown solution as a more comprehensive homegrown solution to the distribution of these palliatives to get to those who really need it?
I believe that government should involve the mass organization, National Association of Nigerian Students, Market Women Association, the Community Development Association, and other organizations that can directly reach out to the masses of our people, the NGOs. And also you see the challenge that is created between the government Southwest and the federal government about whether the grains that were sent to them had expired. So you see that there is deficiency of credibility in the manner of distribution of the palliative. I think this is what the president should look into, whether there is a leakage between the federal government and the states, such that there is diversion, such that there's inadequacy, such that the people that these palliatives are meant for are not actually getting them. So I think that that should be the focus of government, to involve mass-based organization. Thank you, sir.
Legal practitioner Ebun Olu, thank you very much for joining us and for your contribution and news on the hour.
Thank you.